Hey, yo, what is going on, everybody? It's your boy, Mr. DDG94 here with some NBA Live mock break game plans. Today, we are taking on the 2015 NBA champion, Golden State Warriors. Congratulations to them dudes. I picked them to go to win it in seven. They won it in six. So I was one game off. Andre Iguodala is the MVP. Congratulations. That's one of my favorite underrated players. I'm very happy for him. And hopefully Steve Kerr actually lets him start next season. So yeah. And I really wanted to go to a game seven because I didn't want the basketball to end. But, you know, like I said, all good things come to an end, man. Sadly, it was the NBA. Gotta wait till October for the preseason now, man. I mean, I like football, but football, you know, it's too long, too slow. You fall asleep midway through the game. That's just me. I ain't saying football trash. It's just not something to like watch for like, what, 4 hours. They would have the Blake and DeAndre lineup set up when I'm not like, okay. Okay, man. Is it DeAndre and Blake? Yup, it's Blake and DeAndre, so let's jump in. And we are always, why is that every time I come into the game, we always down? I'm still wearing my bread. I'm still wearing my bread one. I gotta change my wardrobe. And congratulations to Golden State, man. Y'all balled out this whole year, man. Congratulations. Shout out to the Bay Area, too, man. Hopefully one day the Raiders get back up there to excellence. One day. Yeah, I'm a Raider fan. Deal with it. One day, Raider Nation. One day. Maybe not this year, but somewhere down the line, Raider Nation, we will achieve excellence again. Shout out to the Raider Nation. Shout out to the Bay Area. Shout out to the base guy. You gotta shout out everybody. It's a good night. It's a good feel night. I actually got a tweet from the Sean O'Brien dude from NBA Live. Well, it wasn't really like a tweet back, but I tweeted at him. It was like a Sean O'Brien something on Twitter. I just asked him about the how the game gonna start up. Can we start up in a practice gym like it was in NBA Live 10? That's all I really wanted, man. And they're not really giving any information on the crew or park mode. Like I said, I still don't know what it is, but till we figure out what it is, I don't know. But man, and it's sad too, because, you know, I say it's sad because all these YouTubers who play 2K are sitting up here posting their opinions, talking about how good Live gonna be this year. Well, you know damn well they not gonna play it on their channel. Now, I'm not sitting here trying to demote these YouTubers. I mean, hey, if they wanna get that, get them views from NBA Live fans, then go right ahead. But just know, when the game comes out, there gonna be no footage of NBA Live on their channel. And if it is NBA Live footage on their channel, it's gonna be every 4 to 3 months. you gonna get some footage. It's gonna be once in a full blue moon. See me, I give you NBA content. I give you NBA live content on every week. You could almost say it's daily, even though it's only 3 days throughout the week. But it's still a lot of content for NBA Live, and I'm pretty sure that's gonna change with NBA Live 16. Cause the way I'm looking at it, I don't think NBA 2K16, they're gonna really change anything. I think they're gonna live off the Spike Lee doing My Career, and that's how they're gonna market their game for the rest of the summer. Meanwhile, the competition is stepping up to the plate. We're talking face scans, we're talking possible crew mode, we're talking realistic ball movement and stuff like that. You know, and I think some news came out today about and this right here really proves my point about 2K and them not knowing a damn thing about basketball. They're sitting up here asking coaches. They're sitting up here asking coaches and stuff like that, like what's the type of play? They're trying to get all the play styles from teams going to the coaches and stuff like that. Now, when I go to NBA Live, I don't think NBA Live goes to the coach. I think NBA Live actually does their homework, and they just so happen to know all the game plans, how everybody moves, where everybody's supposed to be, the spacing and the positioning of all players and stuff like that. Like, I think EA got it down to a T. Like, when you talk about realistic gameplay, I'm talking about playbooks and offensive and defensive sets. If you're into like creating playbooks and stuff like that, oh hell no, not that. Really, DeAndre, really, you gonna let him score on that nasty 360 alley, that 360 layup, which has been, I've seen that a lot as of recently. It's a lot of players using that 360 layup. But anyways, though, man, like I'm just saying, man, like 2K, man, like they gotta ask coaches like how to. Oh my God, Klay Thompson just caught a body. Oh my God. Klay Thompson just got these nuts to the forehead. Klay Thompson just got these nuts to the forehead. I totally forgot what I was talking about now, just because of that dunk. What was I talking about? I totally forgot what I was talking about, just because of that one dunk. What was I talking about? I was talking about NBA Live. I was talking about NBA 2K and coaches and all this stuff. Yeah, so like, anyways though, like I was saying, man, get out of here. Come on, man. They gotta ask the. Like, I totally forgot what I was talking about. But anyways though, man, I wanna go back to these YouTubers real quick, man. Like, I see all these YouTubers who promote 2K. They promote 2K. They'll promote any 2K news. They gonna put that out faster than they gonna put out the NBA Live news. But they just trying to cater to y'all. So I'm just warning y'all now. When NBA Live comes out, watch them play it on the first day it comes out, and watch there be no more gameplay of NBA Live on their channel. So they did all that stuff over the summertime just to get you to watch their channel, just so they can get views. I'm not trying to hurt their view count or nothing like that. I'm not sitting here saying don't go watch their videos, because some of these guys, they have more privileges than I do. In other words, they can go places like E3, or they can go out to places like LA and test the game out, because they can market the game better than I can, because of my stature where I am right now on my YouTube channel. And I'm not jealous of that, but at the same time, I just feel like, you know, they just doing this for views. I'm just keeping it real. They just doing this for views. Me, and then when it comes down to it, you ain't gonna see no gameplay on their channel. So they sitting here, they doing all these interviews with the devs and stuff with EA and stuff like that. But at the end of the day, they still not gonna be playing the game. They gonna scan their face into the game. They gonna play a little bit. They'll probably end up playing a little bit of the Parker Crew mode or whatever. They'll probably end up playing that, but that'll be the only thing they'll show. But that'll be once in a full blue moon. I'll talk some more about it in the second half, though. Alright. I forgot what I was supposed to be talking about in the second half. Because I just saw some BS. I didn't record it, but let me tell you what happened. So, Blake Griffin blocks Harrison Barnes in the paint, right? Steph Curry literally steps out of bounds, but then he zip-lined to the three-point line. I contest the three. They call a foul. He gets a four-point play. Tell me that is not BS right now. I literally just looked at, I don't know. It's hard to believe, but bruh, if I recorded that, I should have recorded that. Just to let y'all see what happened, man. I totally forgot what I was talking about. Totally forgot what I was supposed to be talking about in a second. Totally forgot. But that also reminded me that I never really spoke on like some of the flaws that I saw in that NBA Live 16 trailer. I really want to talk a lot about the creation features. I can't confirm. I can't really complain on them because the game's pretty much in pre-alpha at this point. It's in alpha and beta right now at this point. So I can't really complain. But from what I seen the same hairstyles that was in this game. Like the high top fade, I saw the white boy hair and stuff like that. Now I didn't see them nasty ass cornrows. That's the one thing I didn't see yet. But from what I've seen so far, the hairstyles look the same. I'm kind of mad about that. And another thing too, I'm wondering, like, is the game gonna get your actual facial hair, or can we add our own facial hair into the game? Kind of like how 2K, you can cover up your own facial hair. That's what I do in 2K. I cover up my own facial hair. Yeah. So that was a big problem. But like I said, the game's in pre-alpha. We never know. They could be adding new hairstyles to the game. So I can't really get upset and I can't complain. But I did see that in the creation process when they were showing the Parker Crew clothes, and they were showing you can dress your character, you know, outside of the NBA. Like I saw the hairstyles and stuff like that. They had the Hoop God's face, scan face player, but they had they had him in three different they had three different versions of him. And I saw him with the high top fade, which was in the trailer, and then I saw the other one where he had the white boy hair. Then I saw another one where he had it was another pair of white boy hair that's in this game too. But I ain't trying to be racist either when I say white boy hair. I'm just saying, you know, that's just what I call it, because I'm not white. But that was kind of like a big, you know, for me right now. But like I said, the game's in pre-alpha. There's no telling what they're going to do with the hair. We have yet to see anything before we have some time before we see the finished product, so who knows where they are right now. But if it's good enough to demo at E3, then it's pretty much, almost done. So you can tell they've been working pretty hard on it. And I mean, you know, playing this game now and then looking at Live 16 from the cutscenes, from the not the cutscenes, but the screenshots. And with screenshots and the trailer, it's clear, you can clearly see the difference, but from the lightning and the enhanced depth they went into with the everybody's face and stuff like that. So it's clearly gonna be something different, even though Chris Paul still looks the same. I'm just gonna point that right now. I saw Chris Paul in that trailer. He still looks the same as he does on here. They just added more light to his face. That's pretty much all they did. I think some of these players are still gonna have the same face, and that scares me, because I really hope Serge Ibaka doesn't look like a butt ugly Martian in next year's game. That's the real person I'm looking for right now, Serge Ibaka. So if Serge Ibaka ain't looking ugly in this game, I'll be very happy. Now, what else was I supposed to... What else was I also not happy with? I want to talk about this video I saw. I saw this video from iPod King Carter. They were talking about live motion and stuff like that, the way how they hand the ball off and stuff like that. I really think that's nice, you know, the live motion and how the players are going to hand off the ball. But I wonder, does that work with these post moves? Because, you know, I've been complaining about, you know, PlayStation 2 type animations in this game, and the post moves are really the most cringeworthy part to look at in this entire game. Because the dribbling moves, they're real good, but, you know, it's certain layups and shots. It has more to do with certain players' jump shots, like Chris Paul. Chris Paul's jump shot looks the same, so it's obvious that they're not doing anything with Chris Paul's character. He still had the same shoes on. He has the same face, and he has the same jump shot. But like I said, it's pre-alpha. You never know. There could be some changes to Chris Paul. There could be some changes to other players as the summer goes on, because we are in the off season, so there's no telling they can get some more face scans or not. But other than that, man, I mean, like I said, I can't really complain about everything, because the game's not finished. Until the game's finished and I see the product for myself, I can't really complain. And I'm also, now that I've paid like the full 60 for my NBA 2K, so I will be getting the game on Friday. And since NBA Live 16 comes out on the Tuesday following that Friday, I don't know how I'm gonna work this out, because 2K is gonna come before NBA Live, and I don't know how I'm gonna work it out, because I already be in deep into my career series with NBA 2K. Then NBA Live comes out, then I gotta start that up. I don't know how that's gonna work, but I'll figure it out. It's a lot of, I'm planning ahead right now. I'm really trying to figure things out right now, because I know by that time I'll be doing Madden and stuff like that. And I already know where I'm going with Madden. Madden going to be like a Sunday night thing. It's going to start off Monday, Thursday, Sunday, like the actual NFL games. But like, after a while, you know, when 2K comes out, you know, Madden got to move to the back. You know what I'm saying? Once 2K and NBA Live come out, Madden has to move to the back. And pretty much by then, I pretty much have Madden, I pretty much had taken back Madden at that point, because, I mean, who plays Madden when after 2K comes out? Let's just be honest. Like, who really touches Madden after 2K comes out? Or NBA Live? When the NBA games come out, Madden is pretty much collecting dust.
The Clippers finish with a narrow victory on the scoreboard. When you're able to get steals like they did here today, it greatly improves.
And, yeah. So, like I said in the first half, you know, if, I'm not saying that y'all shouldn't watch these YouTubers, but what I am saying is don't be surprised when they're not uploading any NBA Live. So they pretty much use NBA Live, they use you to get views to make money off the channel. And then you come, so you know me, I always have some NBA Live. Like I said, I'm already planning ahead for both games. I don't know what I'm going to do yet. I'm not going to do the same formula that I'm doing right now, which is Monday, Wednesday, Friday, NBA Live, and then the rest of the week is 2K. I want to do make it different next time around. I don't know how I'm going to do it. I'm going to figure it out. So, yeah, that's pretty much the game, man. We pretty much take care of the new 2015 NBA champion Golden State Warriors, and yeah, that's pretty much about it. I have to see y'all next video. Until then, peace out.
What we have here, a highlight worth a thousand words. There's no question he stood out amongst the rest in today's matchup. Our league scores, here's the latest from around the association. These are the Western Conference standings as we near the playoffs. Here's a look at the upcoming games. On behalf of ESPN on EA Sports, I'm Jalen Rose, and it's been our pleasure to present you with some NBA basketball.